This threat was blowing in from the East Coast.
This girl came in so strong, it was almost intimidating.
There was certainly a move in the late 1970s toward more entertainment hedonism. There was a lot of, you know, youthful drug use, a lot of cocaine, and disco was associated with a lot of that.
Don felt the repetitious dance beats lack of musicianship, and so
the difference between funky music and disco music. When disco evolved, we didn't know what to do.
The chemistry, we could just read each other, and it just comes from a real partnership.
It's worked with three very talented people, ironically, all of whom were connected with Soul Train in one way or another before they became, shall we say, stars.
Remember just bawling in the dressing room. I was crying because there was kind of a bitter intensity. We're getting the evil eye, like, you know.
Don's strategy eventually paid off, and the second time around hit number one on the Billboard R&B charts.
We really thank you, so we would like to present you with a gold.
Oh, what a guy.
If all of us went on the road, I'd sneak back on the Soul Train. But it was my love, so I would still go down there and dance. And thank God I did.
Building on the lock.